Yeah, let's get it going.
Two guys hanging out by the fire.
Yeah.
This is not the way real men build fires, but if you're from Texas like me, usually just throw gasoline in there.
10 months ago, 32-year-old Sandy Russell was 34 stone. Since being diagnosed with non-alcoholic fatty liver disease and a catalog of serious health issues, he's been doing well with the weight loss. But he's fallen off the wagon.
Oh, he's a fine man. I've only got ankle socks on, little thin things too.
I feel like there are still parts of you that, even before the program, you kind of kept contained.
It is hard to, yeah, up to like the age of 9.
Yeah.
It has quite a decent, happy childhood. Round about that time, it turned into like a whole kind of sexual abuse thing. I remember at the time thinking, if I changed how I look, if I was ugly,
yeah,
it wouldn't happen.
Protect you.
To protect me.
Yeah.
Because I couldn't protect my way, you know, myself any other way. And also the food was a comfort, you know.
Yeah.
It was all kind of rolled around that thing happening.
To me, look, I'm not a therapist. I don't act like I can sit down in front of someone with a bunch of issues,
yeah,
and work it out for them. But, you know, it's big of you to be able to sit right here and be able to work the past 10 months and face those things and say,
yeah,
you know what, I'm going to change that.
Yeah.
I'm not going to let that be me, because that's a 9-year-old kid that happened to.
Yeah.
This is Sandy now.
Yeah.
And I think it's, again, man, my hat's off to you. Not that I'm wearing one. But
yeah.
And, you know, what are your goals? What do you want after this program?
As you know, I love to sing.
Yeah.
And I would love to make some kind of professional effort, yeah, of that. And whenever I stand on that stage and get that microphone, I become the most confident person in the world.
Yeah.
And I could take on anything.
So if you could find a way to get that confidence and bring it in to you,
exactly,
to what that you would, need, then
be
you'd be set.
Yeah.
You'd be
I'd be on fire.
You'd be whatever you wanted to be.
Yeah.
Sandy's been admitted to hospital with a liver-related illness, hepatitis B, a virus transmitted by body fluids. Given he already has a sick liver, this is potentially life-threatening. My worry is, Sandy has never really grasped the severity of his situation.
So will you be able to tell me anything from this?
I'll give you a quick crisis of what we can see on this
line.
The spleen is slightly bigger. I think your liver's also a little bit enlarged.
Right.
Okay, so write your report. We'll send that back up to the ward with you.
My friends noticed that I was quite yellow. I made an appointment for the doctor. The levels of my liver was extremely, extremely high, and I needed to get in right away. So, you know, when you hear that, you automatically start panicking. If I don't change, I won't survive. I know for a fact that I won't, because of my health. You know, the situation is that bad that if I don't continue to make it better, then it will end up with me in a box.
Just a week after he was discharged from hospital, Sandy's put on over a stone. Given the warnings from the doctors, this is the most shocking news I could hear. And a stone in 7 days is not something I can ignore.
Sandy.
Who would have thought?
What's in there?
Diet Cola.
Diet Cola?
Or Diet Pepsi, actually.
All right. So how you doing? How you feeling?
All right, yeah.
Yeah?
A lot better than what I was.
Yeah?
Definitely.
Yeah, you were in a bad place, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Is that what it was?
You know, I came here today basically because Last week, I couldn't believe what I saw when I saw the numbers when I you put on a stone.
You and me both.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Man, I mean, is he thinking? Why would he do that at the end of the program? Especially with everything that's stacked against you.
Yeah, yeah.
You've got liver disease. You've got metabolic disease. You have things that are popping up that will kill you. They'll kill you. You just got out of the hospital.
Yeah.
You gotta remember these things, man, because this is your life. Do you want to live it or do you want to end it?
No, I don't want to end it.
You
no
don't
way.
Want to end it?
No,
because
no.
You're telling me otherwise with your actions.
I think I know what I'm doing.
You don't know what you're doing, Sandy.
Well, I think I do. At the beginning of the film, I didn't care whether I was dead or alive.
Well, you didn't care last week either.
I did. I just couldn't see that.
Then you didn't care. You didn't care if you were dead or alive then. Because when you make decisions like that, you're saying, I don't care. When you make decisions like that, you're saying, I don't deserve this. But you do. You deserve to have a good life, man, no matter what's going on in the past, no matter how many bad decisions have been made, no matter how many bad things have happened to you. You deserve a good life. You do. You're a great guy, man. The only way that you're really going to make changes is when you step up to the plate and you do it with nobody else asking you to. You do it because you need to, because you want to, because you have to.
I'm going to tell you this, right? You telling me I'm not going to do it, how do you think that makes me feel then? That makes me think, well, if no one else has got support in me, how can I do it for myself?
No, I think it's just the reality of it. It's accepting the reality of it.
You're just like everyone else out there then.
No, I'm not just like everyone else. Trust me.
People are going to be saying, no, that guy cannot
do it. And trust me, everyone else isn't thinking that. That's in your head, man. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
We know you can do it, but you're not going to do it on your own. You're not. You're not. You're not. You're going to stay inside of that apartment and drive yourself mad. And you're going to eat. And you're going to eat. What's going to be your driving force? You? Are you going to get up and say, I feel like working out after one of your pizzas? I care about you, man. I do. You can do it. And I don't want you to think that I think otherwise. I know you can do it. I told you. You have that person in you. I've seen that person come out. I saw it in LA. Saw it at boot camp. I've seen you. I've seen what you can do. But you don't acknowledge it. You don't acknowledge what you can do.
Listening, Jesse, to this, because I am going to do it. It's about me proving to you guys that I can do it. You know what I mean? I have done it so far, and I know I can do it more. You know, I've had a slip up, yeah, but I have been ill in that, and I think a lot of those things are reasoning behind. Alright, I've not been, you know, I've relaxed myself a lot, but I know how to get back into that frame of mind again, and I am going to do it.
It's great to know Sandy's determined. I really do want him to succeed. He deserves it. He may not be where I'd hoped, but he has lost almost 8 stone. And what this year has done, it's broken him out of the prison he'd created for himself.
I've made a lot of new friends that I didn't know before. You know, my confidence is obviously a lot better. I'm a lot happier than I used to be. My outlook in life is, you know, I actually have an outlook in life now rather than surviving. That's all I can put it down to. All these things that I thought other people could get and I couldn't get is well within my reach now. And I am normal. I am a human being and I deserve to be a human being.
Make some noise then for Simply Divine! Here she comes!
First I was afraid, I was petrified. Kept thinking I could never live without you by my side. But I spent so many nights thinking how you did me wrong. And I grew strong. I learned how to get along. And so you're back from outer space. I just quite here with that sad look upon your face. Let me see your stupid look, should have made you wait. But on this one second, you'd be back to bother me. Go now, go, walk out the door. Just turn around now, cause you're not welcome anymore. When she the one who tried to break you with the bite, you think I'd throw? Think I'd lay down and die, oh no, no, no.